Hello, Trendy Day reporting in.
Hey, Trendies, before I even get started on my rant today, I want to talk about this fucking Big Coal and these fucking AmericasPower.org and all this bullshit and the energy voter commercials. I want to just say how much I fucking hate all those people. I hate the people who make the commercials, I hate the fucking corporations behind them, and I hate the fucking actors, whether they are or not in support of these fucking things. Whether they are or not, that fucking, all of those people that are like, oh, I'm an energy voter, I fucking hate you all. I fucking hate you. God, it's all about money. We're just fucking in the chat room just discussing... our thoughts on oil and coal and fucking these people fucking who lie to make money. And it started because we were talking about that Sandusky bullshit, the rape, and how it was a whole team of fucking people, who were in charge of the football program over there, who decided to cover up a rape scandal, you know, all for fucking money. And, you know, football's more important than a child's life. And just thinking how fucking disgusting these people are. Anybody who had a hand in covering up those rapes should go to fucking prison and get raped themselves. They all should get raped. They all deserve to get raped up their fucking asses. But I really didn't want to talk about that so much today. Even though, yeah, it is a little, it's a little timely. But I really wanted to get into gun control here in the United States. And kind of address Danger Man. If you guys don't know who Danger Man is, he's a friend of mine on YouTube. He's a cool guy, but him and I have completely opposing views on gun control right now. Danger Man is all about protecting children, and I understand that. But let me pull this up a little bit. But at the same time, you know, every time there is some sort of a tragedy, people freak out. Everyone just freaks out, you know, oh, let's pass laws, let's fucking make things fucking hard for everyone to buy guns, let's pull everyone's guns away from them and everything. And that's fine that people, you know, are upset and that they want to fucking do something about it. But passing laws to make it harder for people to buy guns is not going to protect anybody. It's only going to make more barriers for people who need to protect themselves at home. And then... the people who already have guns and people who can get them on the black market. And yeah, you might not realize it, but there's this thing, it's called the black market. That's where you can buy anything you fucking want. At any time, you fucking make a phone call, you buy anything you want. Drugs, guns, people. It doesn't fucking matter. If you got the money, there is a market that will take your money. So passing a law to let law-abiding citizens... to stop law-abiding citizens from purchasing a weapon to protect themselves is not going to protect anybody. All it's going to do is create more fucking sheep and give the bad guys less fear of the sheep to go fucking hunt them down. It's fucking crazy. So, sorry, Danger Guy, Danger Man. I mean, I love you, bro, and I totally respect and appreciate what you do on YouTube, but I disagree with you on this gun thing. You're over there screaming, oh, something has to be done. We have to fight the NRA. No, dude, you don't have to fight the NRA. The NRA is not who went into that movie theater and killed a bunch of people, okay? The NRA is actually, they're pretty good. They're standing up for our Second Amendment rights. Leave them the fuck out of it. They're not even part of this fucking argument. What you need to be worried about is mental health in this country. Talk about pharmaceuticals, and I guarantee you what it's going to come down to is that kid was fucked. That kid went mentally fucking haywire. Something broke inside his brain, and he went crazy. And if he couldn't fucking go out and buy an assault rifle and kill 10 people that way, happy 420, he would have gotten into a fucking truck or, got into a car or something, or strapped a bomb on himself, or gotten a whole bunch of fucking poison, or, you know, it's like, you guys, everyone thinks that, oh, you know, the assault rifle is the fucking key to killing people. It's not. There are so many other ways to murder bunches of people. And if you take their guns away, they're just going to find the next best way to do it. So, that gun control is not the answer. You know, maybe going at it from the back door instead of from the front door. You know, look at what caused this kid to fucking lose it in the first place. And I have a feeling it's going to be mental health issues. And I wouldn't be surprised if Big Pharma plays a fucking role in it. When you look at that kid in court, you see how fucking whacked out his brain is. It just doesn't look like that's from natural causes. But we'll find out as, you know, I want to kind of withhold my judgment until all of the information comes out about what was in this guy's system and what's been going on in his life for the past year that caused him to fucking just snap. People snap. So, yeah, those of you who are in countries that don't have guns, you might not understand our passion for it here in the United States, because I was raised with guns, and I'm used to having them in the house, and I'm used to being able to grab a gun and going outside if I hear some shit outside. So that's the way I want it to be. I like to have a divisive tool that will, you know, protect me if I'm ever in that kind of a situation. And aside from the fact, I live up in the fucking woods up here, man. There's fucking crazy motherfuckers that live in the woods fucking doing this methamphetamine shit. I want to be protected from these fucking crazy motherfuckers. And who's to say some fucking bobcat or fucking mountain lion's not going to grab my dog or something? And I want to be able to protect myself. But mostly it's for people. Mostly it's for fucking people. I'm not going to lie. So, I am... As far as gun control goes now, I mean, they've got bans on automatic weapons just about everywhere. If they want to ban fucking semi-automatic weapons, then fucking come take my goddamn 22s. Come take my fucking, the gun that my father gave me when I was fucking 13 years old. My fucking 1947 military target rifle. If that will make you all feel fucking safer, come fucking take my fucking gun away from me. If that'll make you fucking feel safer. But you know what? It's fucking stupid. You want to take a fucking semi-automatic fucking gun away, a semi-automatic rifle, but you'll leave a semi-automatic fucking pistol, and I can still take fucking 13 shots at you within 5 seconds and put you down in less time than that. So, what's the fucking point? It's so stupid. People get killed every day. Just because a car runs a bunch, just because some old person is in a car, or some drunk motherfucker's in a car, and runs into a fucking, a farmer's market full of fucking people and runs over fucking 10 people and 6 people die. Does that mean we're going to take all the cars off the road? No, not all the cars, just the big cars, just the Ford LTDs. We're just going to take the Lincoln Town cars off because those are the big ones that can do more damage. That's the same fucking ideology. We're going to take all the big cars and trucks off the road because they could do more damage. And if somebody gets behind the wheel of one of those, oh, they could do a lot more damage. Yeah, they can. And you know what? Sad fact of fucking life. We need to start treating each other better, alright? We need to start fucking looking outward and start fucking being a part of other people's lives instead of fucking being all fucking about ourselves and about our own little fucking worlds. You know, maybe if somebody wasn't so fucking caught up in their own world, they would have opened their eyes long enough to know that this kid was about to fucking snap. Nobody noticed. Nobody saw. Because everyone is fucking not concerned about it. You know, we're all concerned about fucking slapping down fucking gun laws and shit when we really need to be concerned about what's making these people go crazy in the first place. Let's talk about that. What makes you go crazy? What makes you fucking lose it? What makes you fucking so mad that you want to go postal? What makes you that fucking angry? I'll name a couple things right now. Big oil. Big pharma. Big fucking coal, big energy, big government, big fucking lies. That's what fucking pisses me off. I hate getting fucking lied to repeatedly by all of these fucking people. And it builds up. But you know what? What takes that fucking stress off of my back? What fucking relieves that? I don't know. Maybe cannabis. Let's try some. See if it works. And I just wonder if he was smoking cannabis at all, if that smart guy. I just wonder if he was in school or they drug tested there or something, you know. And maybe he wasn't allowed to fucking do drugs. Maybe he wasn't allowed to fucking smoke marijuana. You know, I have a feeling, though, he was on a fucking prescription. We'll find out if he's on some kind of a antidepressant. That's what I think it's going to be. He was on a fucking, I have a feeling it's going to be a fucking, either an antidepressant or sleep medication. We'll find out. That's my fucking guess. I'm not always right about shit like that, but man, I got a fucking feeling. I saw a thing on the internet about this guy who said he's ex-military, he's a demolitions expert, and he's retired. It's 4:20 in Amsterdam right now, by the way. however, I'm about to do a dab, too. what this military guy said was, given all of the facts of so far of what he's found out, is he would not have been able to pull off that mass murder in Colorado by himself. He says it would have taken help. He wouldn't have been able to obtain all the ammunition and the fucking the explosives, the protective wear and everything without like at least $10,000 and help from an outside agency. So this guy is like pointing at, you know, oh, it must have been, what, like Al-Qaeda or some fucking outside agency that has helped this kid to go kill a bunch of people. All I can say is, dude, I respect the fact that you provided service for this country. Thank you very much for being ex-military. However, you're wrong. I mean, it's been proven time and time again that it doesn't take much for somebody to put a couple things together to go out and kill a bunch of people. It's just, you know, just accept it, man. Somebody went crazy, somebody went postal, got a gun, and shot a bunch of people. Man, it's in a fucking movie theater, dude. All you had to do was aim for the exits. Nobody was getting out of there. You ever try to get out of a movie theater when there aren't people fucking shooting at you? You can't. It's impossible. Now imagine this. There's a dude with a fucking semi-automatic weapon firing at you. And now you got 200, 300 people all trying to get through two doors at one time. Fuck. Fish in a fucking barrel, dude. I mean, dude knew what he was fucking doing. You know? Dude had it all fucking planned out. And yeah, he was a fucking rocket scientist. That kid was a fucking rocket scientist. You know, he was a smart guy. He just fucking snapped. People snap. Be very interesting to find out if he used cannabis or not. I have a feeling he didn't use cannabis. And I have a feeling that if he did use cannabis, none of that would have ever happened. But then again, you know, I am just hypothesizing here. I could be wrong. I'm guessing. But goddamn, if this shit's right, man, I cannot wait to find out and do another video and say, ah, I was right. Told y'all. All right. Cool. I'm ready to dab. Looks like Cyber's dabbing with me in the trendy ass dabbers room. Cheers. You're welcome, Benny. Take a second to address some of you guys that are sending me messages in YouTube. Listen, if you want to suggest me doing videos, fine. If you don't like the way I'm doing my videos, fuck you. I don't want to fucking hear from you. I'm not changing for you or anybody. So shut the fuck up about it. Oh, we don't like seeing this, and we want to see this, and we don't like that, or na-na-na-na-na. Fuck you. Shut the fuck up. You get what you get. You fucking take it or fucking leave it, motherfucker. All right, you little fucking punk. Everybody's got a fucking opinion, you know? And the trick is to know when to share it and when not to. And if you're gonna fucking start talking shit about my fucking trendies, you are nothing but a fucking piece of shit to me. I don't care. Oh, I love your videos, but I don't want to see all those trendies. Fuck you! They don't want to fucking see you, motherfucker. The only reason they're not on this video is because I fucking forgot to pull up the goddamn screen. I love my fucking trendy, so fuck you. You're like, hey, I'm a trendy too. No, you're not trendy if you sit there and say, oh, I don't want to see everybody else. That's not fucking trendy at all, dude. Those are the people who made all this fucking possible. That's the one thing you're fucking forgetting. Don't forget where you fucking come from, motherfucker. You know? Simple fucking lesson in life right there. Don't forget where you come from. Don't forget who fucking put you where you are. I wouldn't be shit without my subscribers. I remember when I got my first 420 subscribers and I said, you know what? That's all I want. 420 dedicated motherfuckers who are just interested in what I have going on. And it went so much further than that, so fast, it fucking blew up. And I will never forget that first 420. I'll never forget anybody else who came before or after that. It's like, I love you guys, man. And this is why I'm here. I love fucking telling you guys what I have going on in my life. I've gotten to know so many of you. Great fucking people out there. So, you don't like how I set up my fucking video screen. This is how I do when I get trendy, motherfucker. This is what goes on. Yeah, I have no food in my body. I gotta go run and grab me an Ensure fucking vanilla shake. Vanilla. Definitely. As soon as this video is over. Happy 710, by the way. No, I'm not stopping it there. Dude, when I have a headache, I always take Advil. I take 4 Advil. It's the only thing I will do for a fucking headache. I'll take 800 milligrams of ibuprofen. And within 10 minutes, usually, my headache is subsiding. And usually within a half hour, it's gone completely. And I've been using ibuprofen since I broke my neck in that motorcycle accident. And I was like, they had me on Vicodin, and they had me on Percocets or some other shit. I can't remember what the fuck. And I was taking them. It was making my nose itch really bad. And the doctor's like, here, I'm going to give you 800 milligram ibuprofen. I was like, whoa, 800? I was like, I thought they were 200. He's like, yeah, well, this is for extreme pain. He said, and you've got a broken neck and broken ribs. That's real. The real pain was the broken ribs. And he said, take one of these and let me know how it does. I was like, all right. I took those fucking 800 milligram ibuprofens and learned real fast that that shit does work on fucking pain. And I lived on those for a little while, you know, for about a month, because I didn't want to take the heavier shit. So I took the ibuprofen, and it worked, and I realized, man, that shit really worked for me. So once I found something that worked for me, man, I fucking stuck with it. Nothing else ever worked. No aspirin, Tylenol, fucking Anacin, fucking you name it, fucking Bayer, none of that shit ever worked for me. Nothing. Ibuprofen was the only thing. So, I hope that helps somebody out there. Somebody who's never tried it. And they're like, oh, I always have headaches. Ooh, Nay says try Advil. I'll try it. Yeah, fucking try it. Headaches suck, man. No one should have to fucking live with a headache. My best buddy fucking has to deal with them all the time. And I fucking know what it's like. I have to fucking watch him deal with it. It sucks. So, my sister gets migraines. She gets taken out for days at a time. Yeah, anyway, alright, it's almost 20 minutes of me fucking spouting off. So, thanks for watching. Happy 710, happy 420. Please hit subscribe over there somewhere in that general direction. Legalize everywhere. Peace!